हेलो एवरीवन, आई पीयूष सक्सेना ऑफ जागरण पब्लिक स्कूल लखनऊ वेलकम यू टू एसएसटी क्लास। टुडे आई विल टीच यू अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक ऑफ ज्योग्राफी व्हिच इज इंडिया अवर मदरलैंड। इन दिस टॉपिक आई विल टीच यू अबाउट इंडियाज लोकेशन, इट्स एक्सटेंट, इट्स साइज, नेबरिंग कंट्रीज, पोलिटिकल डिवीजन्स एंड फिजिकल डिवीजन्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अबाउट इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन। इंडिया अवर मदरलैंड इज वास्ट, ओल्ड एंड डाइवर्स। इट इज़ वन ऑफ द एंशियंट सिविलाइजेशंस इन द वर्ल्ड। इट हैज़ मेड रिमार्केबल प्रोग्रेस इन द फील्ड ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, इंडस्ट्री, टेक्नोलॉजी एंड इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट। टूडे विद मोर देन 1 बिलियन पीपल, इंडिया इज द सेकेंड मोस्ट पॉपुलस कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड। लोकेशन। इंडिया इज़ द सेवेंथ लार्जेस्ट कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड आफ्टर रशिया, कैनेडा, USA, चाइना, ब्राज़ील एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया। इट लाइज एंटायरली इन द नॉर्दर्न एंड ईस्टर्न हेमिस्फीयर। इट इज़ इन द कॉन्टिनेंट ऑफ एशिया एंड लाइज टू इट्स साउथ एंड एट द हेड ऑफ द इंडियन ओशन। इट इज़ अ लार्ज पेनिनसुला बाउंडेड बाई वाटर बॉडीज ऑन थ्री साइड्स, बे ऑफ बंगाल टू द ईस्ट, अरेबियन सी टू द वेस्ट एंड द इंडियन ओशन टू द साउथ। एक्सटेंट। इंडियाज़ लैटिट्यूडनल एक्सटेंट इज़ 8 degrees 4 minutes नॉर्थ टू 37 degrees 6 minutes नॉर्थ, वेयर एज लॉन्गिट्यूडनल एक्सटेंट इज़ 68 degrees 7 minutes ईस्ट टू 97 degrees 25 minutes ईस्ट। इट्स नॉर्थ साउथ एक्सटेंट इज़ 3,214 kilometers फ्रॉम जम्मू एंड कश्मीर टू कन्याकुमारी एंड ईस्ट वेस्ट एक्सटेंट इज़ 2,933 kilometers फ्रॉम अरुणाचल प्रदेश टू गुजरात। The Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degrees north, passes through the middle of India. Size. The total area of India is 3.28 million square kilometer, which accounts about 2.4% of the total geographical area of the world. Its total land boundary is 15,200 kilometers. The coastline of the mainland of India is 6,100 kilometers, whereas the coastline of the Indian Union, including both island groups Lakshadweep and Andaman and Nicobar Islands, is 7,516.6 kilometers. The southernmost point of the mainland of India is Kanyakumari, whereas the southernmost point of the Indian Union is Indira Point. Neighboring countries. The neighboring countries of India are as follows: China, Nepal and Bhutan in the north, Pakistan and Afghanistan in the west and northwest, Bangladesh and Myanmar in the east, Sri Lanka and Maldives in the south. Political divisions. India is divided into states and union territories for administrative purposes. There are 28 states and 9 union territories. All the northern and northeastern states are landlocked. Rajasthan is the largest and Goa is the smallest state of India. Among the union territories, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands in the Bay of Bengal are the largest, while Lakshadweep Islands in the Arabian Sea are the smallest. Delhi is the national capital. Physical divisions. India can be divided into the following major physical divisions: the Northern Mountains, the Northern Plains, the Peninsular Plateau, the Coastal Plains, the Indian Desert, the Island Group. The Northern Mountains. The Himalayan Mountains stretch over the northern borders of India. These mountain ranges run in a west-east direction from the Indus to the Brahmaputra. The Himalayas represent the highest mountain barrier of the world. They form an arc which covers a distance of about 2400 kilometers. Parallel ranges. The Himalaya consists of three parallel ranges in its longitudinal extent. First, the northernmost range is known as the Great or Inner Himalayas or the Himadri. Second, the range lying to the south of the Himadri is known as Himachal or Lesser Himalayas. Third, the outermost range of the Himalayas is known as Shivaliks. Purvachal Hills. The Brahmaputra marks the easternmost boundary of the Himalayas. Beyond the Dihang Valley, the Himalayas bend sharply to the south and spread along the eastern boundary of India and are known as Purvachal or the Eastern Hills. The Purvachal comprises the Patka Hills, the Naga Hills, Manipur Hills and the Mizo Hills. The Northern Plains. These plains have been formed by the alluvial deposits of the Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra along with their tributaries. It spreads over an area of 7 lakh square kilometers. With a rich soil cover, proper water supply and good climate, it is agriculturally a very productive part of India. Parts of Northern Plains. First, the Punjab-Haryana Plain. This plain is a part of the Indus Basin, most of which lies in Pakistan. The plain of Punjab and Haryana is drained mainly by the Satluj, Ravi and Bias, which are the tributaries of the river Indus. Second, the Ganga Plain. The most extensive part of the Northern Plains is formed by the Ganga and its tributaries. The important tributaries of the Ganga include the Yamuna, Ghagra, Gandak, Kosi and Son. Together they make this plain one of the most fertile in the world. Third, the Brahmaputra Plain. The Brahmaputra Plain has been formed by the Brahmaputra and its tributaries. It is located particularly in Assam. The Brahmaputra rises in Tibet. In their lower reaches, the Brahmaputra and Ganga join in Bangladesh. The waters of the Ganga and the Brahmaputra finally flow into the Bay of Bengal. Subdivision of Northern Plains. According to the variations in relief features, the Northern Plains can be divided into four regions: Habar, Tarai, Bhangar and Khadar. Habar. The rivers, after moving from the mountains, deposit pebbles in a narrow belt of about 8 to 16 km in width, lying parallel to the slopes of the Shivaliks. It is known as Habar. Tarai. South of this belt, the streams and rivers create a wet, swampy and marshy area known as Tarai. Bhangar. The largest part of the Northern Plain is formed of older alluvium. This part is known as Bhangar. Khadar. The younger deposits of the floodplains are called Khadar. They are renewed almost every year and so are fertile. The Peninsular Plateau. To the south of the Northern Plains lies the Peninsular Plateau. Triangular in shape, it is the oldest landform in India. The Peninsular Plateau has two distinct parts, the Malwa Plateau and the Deccan Plateau. The two parts are separated by the Vindhya and Satpura ranges. First, Malwa Plateau. The northern part of the Peninsular Plateau bounded by the Aravalli Range in the west and the Vindhya and Satpura ranges in south is called the Malwa Plateau. Second, the Deccan Plateau. South of the Vindhya and Satpura ranges lies the Deccan Plateau. It is a triangular landmass that lies to the south of the river Narmada. The Deccan Plateau is higher in the west and slopes gently eastwards. There are many east flowing rivers in the Deccan Plateau like Mahanadi, Krishna, Kaveri and Godavari. Coastal plains. The coastal plains extend in the form of a strip along the Bay of Bengal on the east and Arabian Sea on the west. First, the western coast sandwiched between the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea is a narrow plain. Second, it contains three sections, Konkan Coast, Kannada Plain and the Malabar Coast. The eastern coastal plains along the Bay of Bengal are wide and level. In the northern part, it is referred to as Northern Sirkar, while the southern part is known as Coromandel Coast. Large rivers such as the Mahanadi, the Godavari, the Krishna and the Kaveri have formed extensive delta on this coast. Lake Chilka is an important feature along the eastern coast. The Indian Desert. The Indian Desert lies towards the western margins of the Aravalli Hills. It is a sandy plain covered with sand dunes. It receives very low rainfall below 150 mm per year. It has an arid climate with low vegetation cover. Luni is the only large river in this region. The islands. There are two group of islands which are the part of India. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Lakshadweep Islands. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands in the Bay of Bengal lie to the southeast of the Indian mainland. They comprise about 550 islands. These islands are actually the peaks of submerged volcanic mountains. They include the Barren Island, the only active volcano in India. Lakshadweep Islands. The Lakshadweep Islands in the Arabian Sea lie close to the Malabar coast of Kerala, composed of small coral islands. It covers a small area of 32 square kilometers. Kavarathi Island is the administrative headquarter of Lakshadweep. Now, I would like to conclude the chapter. A detailed account of the different physiographic units highlights the unique features of each region. The mountains are the major sources of water and forest wealth. The northern plains are the granaries of the country. The plateau is a storehouse of minerals. The coastal region and the island groups provide sites for fishing and port activities. Thank you.